Hello, it's me, and today I have to examine this other urgent request. This is a Clover 2x2 by Grant Henderson. That is a dear friend that has designed this fantastic puzzle that turns with the three maneuver. I can rotate this puzzle like a 2x2x2. As you can see, this rotation is great. Then I can rotate also is corners, so it's a corner turning, face turning, and also edge turning. If I can rotate, the edge turning is a little bit hardest to turn, but it can turn. I have lubricated the puzzle to turn in this way, and now it's time to scramble this monster here. So it's a really fantastic puzzle because I can rotate all these parts as I want. And it's a really playable puzzle. And I can't wait to solve it. So now I want to continue to scramble this monster. Then we see together how to complete it. So here we go. We have the puzzle full scrambled. So how to start with this monster? I believe that these three central pieces here are connected together. So this means that also this corner here is connected with these three pieces, but it can rotate. As you can see, this is my corner of this side. It can only rotate, but it is the real corner of these three pieces. So my goal is now to complete my 2x2x2 internal. So I've seen that this orange can be connected with this orange, but its colors are not the same. So this means that this is another corner of my orange face. So now I have to find a orange with the blue and the yellow. And it is here. To place this orange and blue in position, I have to do this rotation. So as you can see, these two are now solved. Now we have to place other corners. I have this that has the color white and green, which is this position, is near to this white, so I can rotate the face in this side, and these two whites, these two blue are now joined together. Now we remain only the last orange that is ready to be put here. So now I have the first face with all these parts joined together. And I'm also lucky because I have all the corners in. But if I don't have these corners in, I have to solve the puzzle like a normal 2x2x2. Examining all the algorithm, also if I have only these two corners flipped, I have to apply the same algorithm that I use with the cuboids to exchange these two corners. But in my case, I have now the 2x2x2 already solved. So now how to complete my puzzle? Now it's really important to place and to pair all the edges. My edges that I mean are these two internal parts. So I have only to see. I have this orange and white that is already in, but I need another orange and white that is here. So if I rotate the puzzle in this side temporarily, I can insert this orange and white near to this orange and white, doing this movement here. I have to do this rotation, then this rotation to exchange that piece with this, and then turning back. As you can see, the issue are now paired. And now I can turn back to not destroy this internal layer. Now, the movement of this puzzle looks like a clover 2x2x2. But in that case, I don't have to pay attention with my centers. And in this case, I have to pay a lot of attention, because if I destroy this 2x2 internal, I cannot solve the puzzle. Now it's time to solve other orange faces. I have this orange and blue that is not here, that needs to go, but in this opposite side. So doing this rotation, then exchanging this piece with this white and blue, I can turn back and it will be in this face. Now I have to place this orange and green that is here with the same algorithm. Rotating, if sometimes I catch, I have to do in this way. And it will be in. Then I have to compose again my base. Now, I've seen that I have these two oranges in this side. Here I need a orange and blue that I have here. So with the same algorithm. And insert it. And then I have this orange and yellow that needs to go here. So I have to do templating this way. And then I have to do the same algorithm. Okay, and now I can turn back. Now the last two oranges are in this layer and in this layer. So what do I have to do? I have to place the orange in down position like so. So I have to do this rotation here. Then, this is a blue and orange, so I have to do this setup in this way, and it will be in down position. Then, as you can see, it is in line with this edge. So, if I place this orange and blue in line with this orange and blue in this way, I can do my algorithm. So I have to do one and two rotate. Then I have to rotate this face, and then turning back, it will be in. And here I can turn back easily doing this rotation. Now I have to do another thing. In fact, if I rotate or not, I can rotate now this orange and yellow down like so. Then I have to rotate it in this side. So I have to remember to turn back with my blues back in this side. Now I have to exchange this piece with this. So doing this rotation, exchanging it with this, and then turning back. Now I can turn back with my blue face and then with my orange face, like so. And these four edges are now solved. Now it's time to place these little parts. So I have this to correct. This that needs to go in the white and blue. So I can do this rotation, turning, and then turning back, and this in this position, so I have to turn this one in this side, so it will be near to this, so you can do one and two rotation, then turning this one, and one and two rotation back, and it will be solved. Then I have also this white and green that needs to go here. So doing these two rotations, rotating this one, and one, two back, this edge is now in. Now I have to place all the edges solved in down position. This is in down, this is in down, and this is full reduced. So what do we have to do now? I wanna put this green and white in this position here, rotating this corner and rotating also this corner. I wanna see two best corners to place. So if I rotate in this side, okay, no, so if I rotate this corner with this white and blue in this position, so it's a counterclockwise rotation of this corner, and doing a clockwise rotation of this corner, in conclusion I'll have this yellow and blue in this position. So I wanna do that. So this with a clockwise rotation, so you have to do up, up, down, down, up, up, down, down. Then this corner has been rotated. Now exchanging this corner with this and doing a counterclockwise rotation. Before, you have to do in the, I have done in this side up. Now you have to do in this side up, up, down, down, and again up, up, down, down, and then turn back. As you can see, these two corners has been rotated, and now I have this yellow and blue ready to be exchanged with this yellow and blue. So if I rotate this yellow and blue in this side here, then exchanging this with this, like so, and then turning back, it will be solved. But what happens here? I have caused the rotation of these corners. This algorithm doesn't affect this rotation of this central corners in a clover cube, in a regular clover cube. But in this cube, in this puzzle, I have this problem because these three pieces has been rotated. So what I have to do is now I can do another clockwise rotation of this corner to take this yellow and green here. Yes, and doing a counterclockwise rotation of this corner don't cause anyone. So I'm gonna do the clockwise rotation of this one. So if I do up, up, down, down, up, up, down, down, this is rotated. Now exchanging this with this and doing a counterclockwise rotation, so doing this side up, up, down, down, up, up, down, down. In conclusion, I have, then turning back, in conclusion, I have this orange and green that has been rotated. But I cannot exchange this in this side because this is a corner that I have to rotate back. So nothing, I have to rotate back my position. I have to rotate this corner with a clockwise rotation and this with a counterclockwise rotation to complete my centers. So up, up, down, down, up, up, down, down. Then exchanging this with this and doing a counterclockwise rotation. So if I do up, up, down, down, up, up, down, down, my centers has been completed again. And now I have only to see what do I have to do, because now I have to solve only these two, and these are now completed. So only these two edges needs to be completed. So to solve this case, I believe that if I exchange now this piece, rotating it in this side, like so. Now, if I see which is my orientation that I have to do a counterclockwise rotation. So if I take apart this piece in this side, and if I do a clockwise rotation of this corner, okay, doing a clockwise rotation of this corner, then exchanging this part in this position here, that it will be here, because if I do a clockwise rotation, this red and green will go here. Then exchanging this with this, and undo my clockwise rotation, doing a counterclockwise rotation, it will be in here. So this is my strategy. I have to do a clockwise rotation of this corner here, doing up, up, down, down, up, up, down, down, then stop. As you can see, this corner has been rotated. Now, if I exchange this part with this, rotating in this way, and now what I have to do is only a counterclockwise rotation of this corner. So doing in this side, up, up, down, down, and then up, up, down, down. As you can see, my centers will be again in, and this piece is now ready to be exchanged with this. Placing it opposite, then rotating and turning back. Also, this part is now solved. So now we remain only the last one, that is here. So I can place this white and green in this face. So I can do the same algorithm. Okay. Then back. So as you can see now, if I'm taking apart this white and green in this side, okay, now doing a clockwise rotation of this corner, then a counterclockwise rotation, placing this piece inside here, I complete also this layer here. So if I do up, up, down, down, then up, up, down, down, then I have to exchange this with this. And then I have to do a counterclockwise rotation to solve again my centers. So counterclockwise rotation is that means that I have to start with this side. So up, up, down, down, up, up, down, down. And as you can see now, I have solved also this head here. So now my bottom and middle layer of composed by my edges are now solved. So now I have in the top layer this blue, wow, already in. Then I have this white that is already in, but it needs to be placed in the opposite side. So it's easy for me to exchange all this orbit with this. So doing this rotation, rotating it and placing back. Then this in this side, rotating it and turning back. Also this white and red is now in, like this blue. Now, what do I have to do to solve these two pieces? I have to rotate this green in this side, because this is my side. Then this green in this side. If I do the counterclockwise rotation of this corner, this red and green will exchange this green and red. Then exchanging, when it is rotated, that part that will be here with this, and then turning back with a clockwise rotation of this corner, these two edges will be solved. So what I have to do is a counterclockwise rotation. So I have to do up, up, down, down, then up, up, down, down. Okay, now this part is now here. If I rotate this red and green with this red and yellow, when I turn back with a clockwise rotation of this corner, this yellow and red will pair yellow and red, and this green and red will pair green and red. So if I do up, up, down, down, and then up, up, down, down, as you can see, all the edges are now reduced. Now, solving all the edges, I have only to solve my corners, rotating them to see where they are. So this is correct. This is correct in this way. This is full reduced. Wow, this is also full reduced. I'm lucky because some of these pieces are already in. Now, what do we have to do to continue? I have to place this yellow and blue in this yellow and blue position, so I can make a free cycle with these three pieces. So doing down with this side, so down, then down with this side, as you can see it's paired, then up. I have to do only a down, down, up, up, up and up. As you can see, this piece is now in. Then I have only to see where are my pieces. So I have this white and blue that can go here, but I have to exchanging it with this that I have to place temporarily here. If I do a down, down, up, up with these three pieces, this white and blue will go here. If I do down, down, up, and up, this white and blue is now in, and then this piece can go back. I have this that can go here, but I can place this piece here, exchanging a free cycle with this three. So rotating temporarily in this side, yes, and then doing a down, down, up and up, it will be in. Now I have only to find a way to place other pieces in. So I have this piece. So keep in mind that this white and green is the position of my orange and white. So if I rotate temporarily in this side, temporarily in this side, and temporarily in this side, this is the position of this piece here that can make this free cycle. So doing down, down, up and up, this piece will be in if I rotate back my pieces, as you can see it's now in. Now I want to take this white and red up to here, then to here, then to here, and then to here. So if I do the down, down, up, up with these three, I'm gonna do down, down, up, and up. Then turning back, I have placed this piece in, but I have also this piece that is in this side. So if I do this setup and then doing my down, down, up, up, and then turning back this one, this piece is now in. This can go here, and this can go here. Now I have to place this yellow and orange in the top layer, like so, like so. And this I can rotate in this way. So doing the down, down, up, up with these three. So doing down, down, up, up, and then turning back, turning back, and turning back. As you can see, now I have only the last three pieces to place. So my goal is to place this red and green near to these pieces here. So now it's a really easy part, because it's only a down, down, up, up. Now rotating this side. So I have to do the down, down, up, up with these three, doing up, up, down, and down. And now when I turn back this one, when I turn back this one, and when I turn back this one here, the puzzle is now solved. I hope you like the video, and thanks for watching, guys.